screens right now, thanks in no small part to his spot-on portrayal as Groot. Spot-on? What work does Vin really have to do? Sure, he only has one line and does all his work offset behind a microphone while presumably wearing sweatpants, but damn if he doesn't act the heck out of I Am Groot. To achieve such a fine performance, he recorded Groot's indelible catchphrase for the first Guardians of the Galaxy over 1,000 times to get the right intonation for every occasion. Who knew three words could have so many different intonations and emotions behind them? In a rare feat, Diesel also dubbed the voice work for his character in nearly every foreign rendition of the film. Diesel performed I Am Groot in at least 15 different languages, including Russian, Mandarin, Spanish, Portuguese, Kazakh, Japanese, German, and French. We wonder if there's some kind of record for saying one line this many times in so many languages.
Yo soy Groot. Je suis Groot. Ich bin Groot. Ja, es Groot.
Can you say them all? Vin Diesel's baby Groot voice was unedited. Speaking of his deep voice, when Vin Diesel did his voice work for Groot on the first Guardians of the Galaxy movie, he recorded a majority of his lines on stilts so as to feel more Groot-y. Very method actor. You wonder if Daniel Day-Lewis would approve. Well, we think he might recognize the actual tree costume.
Let's find my tash.
During actual filming, Vin was absent, and a stand-in wearing a Groot head for a hat did all the heavy lifting. For Guardians of the Galaxy 2, it looks like the actor tries to
Natasha!
Specifically, talk like a tree baby. Wait, what? Vin making a baby voice? Yes, the famously deep-toned Diesel once again provides all of Groot's dialogue, despite the fact that the character is now an infant and as such speaks like one. In fact, James Gunn has gone on record saying that they did very little electronic audio to Vin's performance in post-production, because Diesel so perfectly nailed doing a childlike high register. Does baby Groot seem a little less adorable when you realize it's actually a 49-year-old grown man making those sounds? Not one bit. There's a Groot solo spin-off film in the works. When you've got a character that steals every scene,